Who is the Oiki community? A short journey through Europe. The European Climate Initiative, Oiki, is a unique program of the German Federal Environment Ministry, financing projects on climate issues in almost all corners of Europe. Join us on a journey through parts of Europe and get to know some of the climate champions from the Oiki community. We start in the beautiful forests of Slovenia.
Hello, my name is Matej Konjar. The main goal of our project Forest for Future is to provide foundation for optimization of timber volume in relation to increased forest carbon sinks in Slovenia. This will be done through adaptation of forest management planning on national level. Another major goal is to raise awareness between stakeholders, therefore trainings for planners and large forest owners will be organized. So far, we have been adapting forest development models and developing management scenarios that optimize carbon storage. Furthermore, we have been working on information materials and activities that will contribute to better decision-making in future forest management and higher awareness of main stakeholders.
Thank you very much, Matej. Let us now move southeast to the rural region of Serbia, where, just like in many EU member states, local governments are tapping into the co-benefits of regional economic development and climate action. Fortunately, there are Oiki projects supporting this mission.
Hello, my name is Tanja Popovitski and I'm coming from RES Foundation from Belgrade, Serbia. RES Foundation is implementing the Green Rural Deal project. The main objective of that project is to support rural regions in both EU and non-EU countries. We supported the municipality of Priboj in preparation of their transformative strategy, local strategy, which is called the Local Development Plan. The Green Rural Deal project enables exchange between EU and non-EU regions. For example, people from Priboj, from Serbia, can go to Germany and learn from some of the German practices and German experiences and have chance to actually implement some of these practices when they back home.
Thank you, Tanja. How about moving on from the countryside to a city and to our Oiki projects that are catalyzing Europe's energy transition? One of these projects is in Serbia's neighboring country, Bulgaria.
Hello, my name is Ivailo Trindafilov, city of Burgas, Bulgaria. Cities of Burgas and Piraeus are working actively through the years for the energy transition of their territory. As we have invested a large amount of budget for building renovation, replacement of cooling and heating systems in public buildings, as well as replacing our street lightings with innovative bulbs. EUKI gave us the opportunity to implement an idea that we had a long time ago. Our idea was to support the local stakeholders in the first phase, the initiation phase of implementation of photovoltaic projects. We will develop a digital platform, set an administrative unit, and implement information campaigns directed to business, local administration, and citizens.
Thanks for a great example from Bulgaria, Ivailo. Now, let's travel to Romania. There, Silvia raises awareness to bring about transformation and change, starting at the individual level.
Our project is called RIFI, Reducing the Ecological Footprint Through Eco-Awareness. And what our aim is actually in the name. We want to sensitize young people to using less resources through the love of nature and through the love of life. We have selected the children in Iași and in Bucharest. We took them to Brăila, Maramureș, where we had the workshops, both practical and theoretical. And we are now doing e-learning modules, teaching materials, a play is being written, a film is being cut, and this is going to lead on to a curriculum. When I started to work with young children nearly 30 years ago, of course, I talked about the environment and environmental issues because it's one of my lifelong passions. But people thought either I was mad or they were simply not interested. And now, through Oiki, we have this marvelous project and we are riding up right on the crest of the wave of the Zeitgeist. We're just a tiny drop on a huge and very hot stove. And if we're enough drops, we can cool it.
Thank you, Sylvia. Here we go to beautiful Budapest. A lot of money is invested in climate action every year by the EU. But how can we know that it will be used in a way that actually benefits the climate? András?
Hello, IKEA community. I am working with my team on a project called Towards a Climate Neutral EU, Efficient Allocation of EU Funds. The aim of our project is to make proposals on how to improve the way EU money is used in Europe. Indeed, we found out that the current system of EU funding has often caused serious damage to the climate and the environment, and therefore this system needs to be changed profoundly. In our ELK project, Hungarian NGOs have presented more than 260 concrete recommendations to the national governments, the European Commission, and the European Parliament on possible ways to improve the system of EU funding. Among others, we propose methods to increase transparency and public participation and to ensure that national spending does not contradict the aims of EU funding. We have been also collecting and disseminating best and worst practice examples of the use of EU funds. All this is extremely important. If EU money is used in an appropriate manner, it can greatly contribute to achieving the EU's climate targets.
Thanks, András, and good luck with your project. Another fascinating project, based in Slovakia, supports green startups in developing and implementing green business ideas. Please tell us more about it, Robert.
Hi, I'm Robert Biskup. First, we found out about the OIC community more than a year ago, when our long-term project partner based in Germany, FIAP, contacted us with an initial project concept or project idea, which now turned into the ongoing project that we're implementing, which is called the Green Tech Lab, or GTL. I think that this project is very relevant for Europe because it focuses on the support of sustainable and green entrepreneurship. It also focuses on green topics of participating regions, which is tremendously important, especially in the context of climate change issue and the ambitious tools that Europe has set in order to tackle it successfully.
Thanks, Robert. Next station, Poland. It's the European Year of Rail. If we want to achieve sustainable and climate-friendly mobility, we can't look beyond the train. Łukasz and his team are working on improving the existing cross-border rail transport system in the EU.
Hello, I'm Łukasz Janeczko from the Civil Affairs Institute from Poland. We believe that Europe needs a more attractive and connected rail system to offer an alternative to flights, reduce transport emissions, and give a green boost to the economy. But to achieve a shift to rail and reduce EU transport emissions, investments into rail infrastructure, enhance cross-border cooperation, simplify booking options, and fair taxation across transport modes are required. We intend to focus on concrete solutions such as rail introduction of night trains or easy search and booking of international train connections. We will support policymakers and the rail industry in implementing these solutions, which will restore the renaissance of rail in Europe.
Renaissance of rail? That sounds promising. Our next stop, Estonia. In the framework of this transboundary project, partners advocate for climate policy as a central issue of EU reforms. It is a contribution to Europe's goal of becoming climate neutral by 2050. Crystal, what is your experience with this project?
Hi, I am Krista from Estonia. Since last year, we have been involved in a project related to the EU Climate Action Dialogue. It deals with a conference on the future of Europe and it's linked to climate policy. It's been a great experience being part of this professional expert group from different member states. We have partners from Germany, Poland, Czech Republic, Italy, Romania, Slovenia, and a few other countries. We've been having nice and fruitful discussions about climate topics in our countries.
Thanks, Crystal. This brings us back to Slovenia, where we started and where Linda is currently. She will give us another example how Oiki finance projects can build a bridge between municipalities, nations, and the EU level.
My name is Linda Beischlag. The project Three Presidencies for Climate, Think European, Act Local, short 3 for Climate, connects 6 cities and 6 schools from Germany, Portugal, and Slovenia to jointly take action towards climate neutrality. While these 3 countries hold the trio presidency of the Council of the EU in 2020 and 2021. Virtual study tours, teacher exchange visits, climate action days, and a student contest have allowed municipal representatives, teachers, and students to get to know each other and to learn from their peers' experiences in implementing local climate action. 3 for Climate is a multi-level governance project and provides an opportunity for local, national, and European decision makers to connect and to better understand each other's interests and move towards potential solutions for a carbon neutral future.
Thank you, Linda, and everyone from the Oiki community who contributes to our common climate goals and who strives towards a livable future in Europe and beyond. By the way, if I wanted to set up such a project myself, what advice would you have for me?
Climate change mitigation has to be our priority and require participation of all sectors and individuals.
With daily communication and cooperation with local partners and their involvement from the beginning.
First, try to analyze the real concrete needs and problems of the target group.
Have a project for which you are burning. Be exact with the finances and use the opportunity that Oiki is giving you.
The Oiki community is a great source of knowledge and a platform for exchange in the field of climate action in the EU. It provides the opportunity to find synergies and ways to collaborate between projects and to build on each other's experiences.
This journey is not over yet. It will continue until we have created a climate neutral Europe.